A rational number is a number that can be written as a fraction, whose numerator and denominator are integers. For example, 0.5 is a rational number because it can be written as 1 over 2, and 1 and 2 are integers. An irrational number is a number that cannot be written as a fraction of two integers. 2,500 years ago, the Pythagoreans were on the cutting edge of mathematics, and they thought that all numbers are rational. But that belief was short-lived, because around that time, the Pythagorean Hippasus presented a proof that changed the course of mathematics to this day. And it goes something like this. Every even number you can think of can be represented as 2 times some integer. So the sum of two even numbers can be represented as 2 times integer m plus 2 times integer n. Factor out the 2, and we have 2 times m plus n. The sum of two integers is another integer, and 2 times an integer is even. Therefore, an even number plus an even number is an even number. Every odd number you can think of can be represented as 1 plus some even number. So the square of an odd number can be represented as 1 plus 2 times integer n, all squared. Expanding this equation and collecting like terms, we have 1 plus 4n plus 4n squared. Let's factor a 2 out of the last two terms. 2n is an integer, and so is 2n squared, which means that the last two terms are even. The sum of two even numbers is an even number, and 1 plus an even number is an odd number. Therefore, an odd number squared is an odd number. I know that these seem like trivial properties and proofs, but they'll come in handy soon enough. Take a 1x1 square. Let's represent the diagonal with the letter h. According to the Pythagorean theorem, 1 squared plus 1 squared equals h squared. Rearranging the equation a little, we can deduce that the length of the diagonal is the square root of 2. Let's assume that the square root of 2 is a rational number. We'll write it as the integer p over the integer q. Let's also assume that this fraction is in reduced form, so p and q have no common factors aside from 1. P and q each can either be odd or even, so there are 4 possible combinations of p and q. Odd and even, even and odd and odd, and even and even. As discussed earlier, every even number can be represented as 2 times an integer. So if both p and q are even, then they both have 2 as a factor, which contradicts the initial assumption that p and q have no common factors aside from 1. So p and q cannot both be even. Let's cross out that option. Rearranging this equation a little, you get this equation. 2q squared equals p squared. Q squared is an integer, and 2 times any integer is an even number. Since p squared is equal to that, p squared must also be even. And as discussed earlier, every odd number squared is odd. Since p squared is even, p must also be even. So if we go back to our table, there is only one available combination with p being even. So we can conclude that q is odd. Or can we? If p is even, it can be written as 2 times some integer. Let's call it integer a. Let's bring back the equation from earlier and plug in p equals 2a. And we get 2q squared equals 4a squared, which simplifies to q squared equals 2a squared. And this should look familiar. A squared is an integer, and 2 times any integer is an even number. Since q squared is equal to that, q squared must also be even. Every odd number squared is odd, and since we've determined that q squared is even, q must also be even. So if we go back to our table, there is only one available combination with Q being even. But this combination has P being odd, and we've already determined that P must be even. If there is a solution to this problem, it must be that P and Q satisfy both combinations. P and Q each are both odd and even. And that's a contradiction, meaning that our assumption that root 2 is a rational number is false. Root 2 cannot be written as the ratio of two integers. And so we conclude that root 2 is an irrational number. But did we prove that root 2 is a number? What else could it be? Let me know your thoughts in the comments, and thanks for watching.